Good morning to all. Welcome to the course Metrology and Machine Tools. Myself, Gruvai Naidu, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering. This course will cover what are the different types of machine tools generally used in the manufacturing process and what are the different operations you can perform on the machine tools. Now, today's in the lecture one, I'm going to give you the overview of the machining process. So first of all, let's see what is the meaning of machining. Machining is any of various process in which a piece of raw material is cut into a desired final shape and size by a controlled material removal process. So here it is any process in which a workpiece is going to be converted into desired shape by removing the material. So let's see this video. We are going to get some idea about the what is the machining process, how we are going to convert the raw material into a desired part. Let's see, for example, this is the one cylindrical bar. So this is a raw material. Now we are going to convert this raw material into desired part according to the given dimensions. Now we'll see how we are going to convert this raw material into desired part. This is a raw material. So we are going to remove some material from the base metal. So to get the desired shape and size. So in the next classes, we will discuss about the in detail about the different operations you can perform. Just we can observe how we are going to convert this raw material into the desired shape. So here we are doing the threading operation. So this is the final object. So you can observe. So by removing some material from the base metal, we'll get this final object, desired portion. So this is the final object. So we done some operations. We done some operation to convert the raw material into desired part. So this complete process is called as a machining. So machining is nothing but it is a process of converting the raw material into desired part by following a controlled material removal process. So next, so examples: turning, drilling, milling, grinding, anything. So many operations are there in a machine where you following many operations to convert the raw material into desired portion. Now coming to the metal cutting. So metal cutting is the process of removing unwanted material in the form of chips from a block of metal using cutting tool. So if you remove the material in the form of chips from the base material, that is called as a metal cutting. So the classification of machining process. The machining process can be classified into two types. One is the chip removal process, and next one is the non-chip removal process. You can call it as a chipless process. So what is a chip removal process? In chip removal process, the layers of metal from the parent metal, we can call it as a workpiece, separated in the form of chips to obtain the required dimension and shape. That means if you want to get the required shape from the base metal, from the workpiece, so you have to remove the material from the workpiece in the form of chips. In the form of chips. So that process is called as a chip removal process. Now we'll see one example for this chip removal process. Now here, this is the base metal. So we want to remove some material from this base metal. Now if you observe, so how the material is removed, this is the finished part and this is the base surface. So the material is removed in the form of chips. You can observe the material is removed in the small segments. So those are called as the chips. This is called as a chip. So that means if the material is removed in the form of small segments of the material, so that is called as a chip removal process. So this is about the chip removal process. So examples in this process, a compressive force is applied to shear off the material in the small pieces known as the chips. So we are going to move the cutting tool against the rotating workpiece. That means we are applying some compressive force. We are going to apply some compressive force to get the chips. So there are various chip removal processes are there. So some here I'm giving the some only a few list. So there are many number of chip removal processes are there. So examples are turning, drilling, milling, and shaping, slotting, grinding, honing. So in today's lecture, just I'm going to give some overview of all these processes. Next lectures, so we are going to discuss about the each and every process in depth, in detail. Now let's see. So what is the meaning of turning process? Here, if you observe this image, this is the base metal. So I want to remove some amount of metal. For example, let's see. For example, we have some cylindrical rod. So the diameter of this here, let's see. For example, here, this is the diameter. Let's say, for example, the diameter of this rod, base metal. The diameter of this base metal is, for example, 10 mm. 10 mm. But I need only 8 mm diameter. I want to remove some material from this one. I need only 8 mm material from this. Here, I need only 8 mm diameter. So this base one is the. So here, this is a base one. So from this 10 mm, I want to convert this 10 mm diameter into 8 mm. So that means you have to remove some 2 mm material from the base workpiece. So that material is going to be removed by the turning operation. This is a base metal and this is a cutting tool. We are moving the cutting tool. Okay, the workpiece is going to be rotating. We are moving the cutting tool in the direction parallel to the axis of rotation of the workpiece. So by moving the cutting tool against the rotating workpiece, we are going to remove the material. So this process is called a turning operation. Now next, we'll see the definition of the turning. Turning is the machining operation that produces cylindrical part. This is only to use to produce the cylindrical parts only. So in turning, a cutting tool with a single cutting edge is used to remove material from a rotating workpiece to generate cylindrical shape. Here we are moving the cutting tool against the rotating workpiece to get the required shape. Next, coming to the drawing. So drilling. So this is a drilling operation. So everyone know that what is the meaning of drilling. Drilling is nothing but making cylindrical holes of circular cross, or making a hole of circular cross section in a solid material. Here, this one is the base metal workpiece. We are going to make some hole. This is a hole by using this drill bit. Now here, we are going to move this cutting tool. We are going to remove this cutting tool. In general, the drill bit is going to be rotating. The drill bit is going to be rotating like this in this direction. And we are going to move this rotating cutting tool into the workpiece. So by moving this rotating cutting tool inside the workpiece, so it is the cutting tool is going to be remove the material from the workpiece. By removing the material, it makes some hole. So this is about the drilling operation. So next one here, the drill bit is usually a rotary cutting tool. Often it is a multi-point. It has a multi-point cutting edges. Next, boring. So boring is nothing but it is a process of enlarging a hole that has already been drilled by means of a single point cutting tool. So here, if you observe in this one, so we already made some hole by using the drilling operation. For example, this is a hole already we made in the workpiece. Let's say, for example, the diameter of the hole is some 8 mm. The diameter of the hole is some 8 mm diameter. Is a 8 mm diameter. So, but I want to enlarge the diameter. I want to enlarge the diameter. So I need only 10 mm diameter. Let's say, for example, this is a diameter. I need 10 mm diameter. I want to make it as a 10 mm diameter. Now, how we are going to do? So here we are going to enlarge the hole which is already drilled. So for that process is called as a boring operation. So boring is nothing but it is a process of enlarging a hole that has already been drilled by means of a single point cutting tool. So next one, milling operation. So this is also one type of cutting process. Here we are using the milling cutter. The milling cutter is going to be rotating. We are going to move the workpiece. Here, these sharp edges, all these are the sharp edges. These sharp edges are going to remove the material. So that means in any operation, we are going to remove the material in the form of chips only. So the chips is nothing but small segments. The material is removed in the form of small segments. So these are called as a chip removal process. So there are other examples also, the shaping, planing, and the slotting operations. Let's see here, if you want to make these slots, so we are going to use the shaping, planing, and the slotting. So shaping, planing, and slotting can be defined as the processes of removing metal from a surface in horizontal, vertical, and inclined positions to produce a flat or plane surfaces, slots, and grooves by means of a relative reciprocating motion between the tool and the workpiece. And here, if you observe this one, relative reciprocating motion between the tool and the workpiece. If you want to remove the material from the workpiece, you should maintain the relative motion between the workpiece and the cutting tool. So this we'll discuss in the next classes. So what type of motion you have to maintain, relation maintain between the cutting tool and the workpiece. Now here, if you want to make this type of slots, we are going to use the either shaping or planing or slotting operations. So in all the operation, we are going to remove the material in the form of chips only. Next, this is also one type of chip removal process, abrasive machining. So first of all, you should know the what is the meaning of abrasive machining. Abrasive machining is a machining process where the material is removed from a workpiece by using abrasive particles. In the previous machining process, if you go for the turning or drilling or milling, whatever it may be, if you take any one of the machining process out of the turning, drilling, milling, so we are using one milling cutter in case of milling and drill bit for the drilling purpose. That means we are using the cutting tools for the machining. But here in the abrasive process, we are going to use the abrasive particles, more number of abrasive particles we are using to remove the material. Now, abrasive machining process can be divided into two categories. One is a bonded abrasive process or fixed one. So example is grinding, honing. And next one is a loose abrasive process that is called as a polishing or lapping. So while you are discussing about the grinding, we'll discuss in depth about the what is the meaning of bonded abrasive particles and loose abrasive process. Let's go for the grinding. So grinding is will come under the bonded abrasive particles. The reason is here all the abrasive particles are attached to one surface, attached to one object, one surface. So all are attached. So all are fixed. So that's why it is called as a bonded or fixed. So grinding is an abrasive machining process that uses a grinding wheel as a cutting tool. This is a grinding wheel. So it has a multi-point cutting tools. Number of abrasive particles are attached to the grinding. So grinding is used generally. This abrasive machining process is used for the finishing process. After completion of the metal cutting, if you want to get the high accuracy surface finish, so we are going to go for the finishing operations. So that's why grinding is used to finish the workpiece that must show high surface quality and high accuracy of shape and dimension. So these will come under the finishing surfaces, finishing process. So honing also there. So honing is used to clear, finish the internal surface of the bores. Here we are using the honing tool. So you can see the definition. Honing is an abrasive machining process that produces a precision surface on a metal workpiece by scrubbing an abrasive grinding stone or a grinding wheel against it along a controlled path. So this is the honing tool. We are going to move the honing tool inside this workpiece to clear. So let's observe. You can observe this how the surface is very clean. So it's an engine block. Okay, now so you have to maintain the high accuracy surface finish for the engine block. So because if the surface is rough, automatically, because in the cylinders, if you go for the internal surface of the cylinder and piston cylinder, if the internal surface of the cylinder is not smooth, automatically if the piston is sliding inside the cylinder, because of the roughness, friction is going to be generated. Because of the friction, heat is going to be generated. So because of the heat, so we are going to get the very huge damage. So that's why to avoid all these things, so you have to maintain the high accurate surface finish. To get that high accurate surface finishes, we are going to use this finishing process. You can go for the grinding or honing or lapping, whatever it may be. So lapping is also one type of machining process, but here, so we are using the loose abrasive particles. Just the abrasive particles is just like the powder we are using normal polishing purpose. So in case of the grinding and the honing, so we are fixing the all the abrasive particles to a solid disc or whatever it may be. So but here in the lapping, we are using the loose abrasive particles. So lapping is a machining process in which two surfaces are rubbed together with an abrasive between them by hand movement or by using a mesh. So this is about the chip removal process. Now coming to in all the chip removal process, we are going to remove the material from the workpieces. Now coming to the non-chip removal process. So what is the meaning of non-chip removal process? In this non-chip removal process, the required form and dimension obtained by without removing the material from the workpiece. Here we are not cut the material. We are not removing the material from the workpieces, but we are applying some force to convert the raw material into desired shape. So we'll see one example, one video. Here, now we'll go for the rolling. Rolling is an example of non-chip removal process. Let's see here, this is the base material and this one is the required part. I want to decrease this thickness or diameter, whatever. So here we are going to move this workpiece. We are going to send the workpiece in between the two rollers. We are heating. This is called as a hot rolling. Hot rolling means we are heating the metal up to the recrystallization temperature, and after that we are sending this workpiece in between the two rollers. By applying the force, where the rollers is going to, by applying the force when this metal is moving in between these two rollers, okay, now the material is dimension is going to be changes. I think already this process already covered in the last semester in our production technology subject. You know the rolling, what is the meaning of rolling and what are the different types of rolling process. So these are called as a non-chip removal process. Here we are not removing any material, just we are changing its dimensions. We are not separating any material from the base metal. So that's why it is called as a non-chip removal process. Let's see, observe. This is a base metal workpiece. So now we are sending this workpiece in between the two rollers. We can observe the dimensions. So here we can observe the thickness is going to be changes. So the length is going to be, that means if the one damage, the one dimension is increased, automatically the other dimension is going to be decreases. If the length is increasing, means the thickness is going to be decreases. So like this, here in the non-chip removal process, we are not separating metal, we are not removing the metal material from the workpiece. There's a thing. The examples for this one is forging, rolling, spinning, stamping, and embossing. So I think almost many of the non-chip removal process are covered in our production technology subject. So now this is about the introduction to the machining process. Now next, in the next class onwards, so we will discuss about the what is the different types of machine tools we are using, and what are the specifications and all these things. Okay, thank you.